So what I want to do here is take a look at how we would go about auditing our street names or our names for ways in such a way that we can get a sense for what's going to need to be fixed here. All right? So let me walk you through this code in detail. This is a modified version of the code we looked at back in lesson 3. And what we're doing here is using element tree, the C version. And if we scroll down, this is actually one of the more interesting parts of this code. So let's take it one step at a time. So here we're using iter parse, part of the element tree module. Okay, and a couple of things I want to point out here. Again, remember that this data set is enormous, almost 2 gigabytes. So we can't read the whole thing into memory as an XML tree or an element tree. Rather, what we have to do is iteratively parse it, or parse it using event-based parsing, and you can see some of that language coming out here. Essentially, the way iterparse works is every time it sees one of the events that we've specified here, it is going to emit the event and the element that it found. Okay, so let me break that down in terms of the data specifically. The way I've set this code up is anytime it sees a start tag, okay, that's what this says here, right? And to events, we actually have to pass it a tuple, okay? We can pass it any number of recognized events, but in this case, I'm only concerned with getting start tag events, so I just want iterparse to generate the next item in its iteration when it sees a start tag. And in Python, we need to end tuples with a comma, okay? So make sure you do that if you're gonna use code like this, okay? And then what I'm saying here in the next line is, all right, if that element you kicked out to me, again, remember this is a tag, so this is going to be an object representation, a Python object, that essentially represents some sort of start tag, a node or a way or a relation or maybe member here, okay? And then what I'm doing here is I'm filtering. I'm saying, okay, the tag property for this element object that you kicked out has to be way. That has to be the value of it, okay? If that's the case, then what I want to do is for that element, I want to call the iter method, okay? Now, the iter method is designed so that it will return in an iteration all of the subtags, the tags nested within this particular element, whatever that is. So going back to the documentation here, it would give me back for this particular start tag each and every one of the tags that are nested within it. Okay, I can optionally specify to the iter method the value of a particular tag that I would like to get back. And what this does then is modifies the behavior of iter so that rather than giving me back all of the tags that are nested within a particular start tag, it will just give me those that are named according to the constraint that I've specified. So here, I've said, just give me back those that are tags. Okay, so I would just get back these.